Good afternoon. My name is João Soares. Let me just go to my camera. Sorry. Sorry for this, because I thought the camera was on. Okay, I think now, are you seeing me?
Yes, okay. Perfect.
So this paper is titled Joint Optimal Location of Electric Vehicle Charging Stations and Renewable Energy Source Including CO2 Emissions. It is a collaboration with São Paulo State University and the Polytechnic of Porto, where I belong from. These authors from State São Paulo State University are Ian and John Freddy Franco. And on the line is Fernando Lozama and Professor Zita Ball. I think she is not here, but she's also a co-author. So this will be the outline of the presentation. I will start with the introduction to this expansion planning problem, then the two-stage stochastic formulation, objective function and constraints, how we created the scenarios and the for modeling the uncertainty in this problem. Then I will briefly summarize all of the proposed approach, show you some tests and results, and finally the conclusions. So this work is about planning for the future, is expansion planning problem in the smart distribution networks. And the idea is to locate electric vehicle charging stations and renewable energy units in the grid, and we are doing this for a planning horizon of 10 years. We know for sure that electric vehicles are going to be in huge amounts. Of course, there is uncertainty on how much it is exactly, but we heard from previous speakers today that China is one of the country leaders, and Denmark in its own way. So we believe this to be a very important problem for many countries in the coming years. Of course, this will be accompanied with renewable energy source, because it does not make sense to charge our cars if our energy is not sustainable and clean. And we know this is also motivated and is a big force by energy policies that regulate issues related with environmental concerns. So the contribution of our work is threefold. We propose, like I said in the outline, a two-stage stochastic programming model to simultaneously see the best locations from our EVCS, our electric vehicle charging stations, and our renewable energy source units. We also take into account the minimization of costs and the CO2 emissions. We transform our mixed integer nonlinear program model into a MILP model, a linear programming model. And we use some methods to generate our scenarios for the planning horizon. Our two-stage stochastic formulation has two stages. One is the here and now decisions, the investment decisions, where we need to invest now in our renewable energy units and in the electric vehicle charging stations. And wait and see solutions are the second stage, related with the operational costs. So this is future, the future problem, what will happen. And this is the scenarios we must realize and take into account. Let me just put, okay. In our first stage, we have, like I said, the renewable energy source units costs and the electric vehicle charging stations. Our operational costs are the energy that is imported by the substation. So with one of the operational costs we take into account as in the several scenarios for the future. We also take into account the operation and maintenance of the renewable energy source and the cost for the CO2 emissions. So we have emissions from the energy imported in the substation and emissions related with the operation and maintenance of renewable energy sources. The constraints of our model related with the operational limits of voltage nodes and so on, and Kirchhoff laws have been linearized using a piecewise linearization model. We also consider investment limits, like how many renewable energy sources I want to have, and how many electric vehicle charging stations I want to have as a maximum limit. In order to generate our demand of our electric cars, we have a randomized scenario generation method in which for each EV and for each day we loop and we assign randomly a distance, like between 10 kilometers and 200. So we loop this for every car, we calculate the state of charge, and then we allocate, taking into account previous charging behaviors available in the literature, we allocate how much this charging will be along the days. So we end up with one scenario for 1 year. Here you can see the red line is the average of the charging profile of our generated vehicles. And the blue line corresponds to the peak day. It happens to be on the day 235. And this corresponds to about 4.6 megawatts of power. So you can have different charging profiles. Here we have some more statistics about our scenario. We have a probability distribution function that shows for initial state of charge and the final state of charge. For easier analysis, we have different categories. Each category corresponds to 10%. So we can see that most of our cars, the initial state of charge will be around up to 50%, more or less. Here is the cumulative distribution function for the same scenario of cars. You can see that the state of charge will be between 0 and 50%. Most of the cars will be on this region, 84%, like I told. But we have cars, but we also have to consider those certainty on the other parameters, like the demand, the wind speed that affects the wind turbine generation, and the sun radiation, irradiation that affects the PV generation. So the EV's demands are generated with the previous method I show you. These ones come from the database of Renewable Ninja for the northeast part of Brazil. So we use data from that database. And then we divide these into groups. We get the winter and day of the winter, night of the winter, summer day and summer night with some logs. We group this by using the clustering algorithm, key means. And then in the end, we obtain around 40 scenarios. So we have our planning problem and we have to decide for these 40 scenarios. Like I said, our mixed integer nonlinear programming is linearized into a MILP model that is more tractable in terms of computational time. And also there is efficient models for MILP problems, while for MINILP they are not so efficient. Here we can solve this problem in a quite reasonable amount of time and without convergence problems. And we will obtain our investment decisions for electric vehicle charging stations and the renewable energy sources. This is to summarize the approach. Regarding the tests and results, we apply these on 34-node distribution network, a medium voltage network of 13.5 kilovolt. We have some operational constraints here. The planning horizon is 10 years, and we have a multi-stage decision making here for proprietors. So in the first year, and then the next 5 years of the project. In order to make some comparisons, we have four cases. The first case does not consider investments in the electric vehicle charging stations. We just invest in renewable energy sources in the grid. In the case two, the main proposal. We have a joint optimal allocation of both the EV charging stations and the renewable energy source units. And these two cases are only sensitivity analysis. So we have used different costs for the CO2 emissions to see how much it affects our investment cost. And we also use different levels of electric vehicle penetrations from our original scenario. And these tables basically summarize the results that we have of our investments. So at least for the case one and case two. Like I said, case one has no investment decisions in the EV charging stations, so it's zero. We have investments in PV generators and wind turbines. The total investment cost is around $20.7 million. And the operational costs for the 10 years, if we make these investments and we consider the 40 scenarios, is around 137, if we round, 137 million. The emissions will be 536 kilotons. If we compare when we invest in EV charging stations, we have around 1.8 million investment in EV charging stations. We reduce a bit the investment in PVs, we maintain in the winds, and the total cost is 22 million now, but we are able to reduce the operational costs by around 3.6%. So we reduce from 137 million to $132 million of operational costs. And furthermore, we are able, and that's also important, we are able not only to reduce operational costs, but also to reduce our emissions in about 5.5% compared with case one. Case three is, like I said, a sensitivity analysis from the base case, from case two. So we use different emission rates for the CO2 emissions, and we see how this affects the investment cost. The total investment cost is the investment plus the operational cost. Of course, if we increase the cost for the CO2 emissions, the program tries to reduce this by investing more in PVs and winds, but that will come at a cost. So we invest more in renewables. We go from 20 million to more than the twofold, 45 million, but we only reduce slightly the CO2 emissions here, but the investment costs starts to skyrocket. We did the same, but for changing the penetration levels of our electric vehicles and to see how much that affects. So if we go from 100%, which is our base case, to more 40%, we'll go up to 150 million, is a present cost value of the project. And if we reduce the penetration of our cars, we have a little bit, of course, less cost for our project. So to conclude, we propose a two-stage stochastic programming model that will consider uncertainties for the future, because we are dealing with renewable energy sources investments, and we are dealing with electric vehicles. So all of that is uncertain. So it's good that we try to have a scenario-based approach. We see that when we make the sensitivity analysis, that if we want to reduce CO2 emission, we have to, of course, increase our investments in PV and wind turbines, renewable energy sources. The reduction of CO2 results in increasing costs, there is a conflicting cost between this investment and the emission reduction. Our future work will attempt to model this problem using robust optimization, because sometimes in the decision maker is interested in dealing with risk. So the worst case scenario might be worth to take a look. So I want to thank you for your attention. This paper is part of ongoing projects in Brazil, supported by FAPEST, and in Portugal, a synergetic project supported by the Portuguese Science Foundation. So thank you very much.